Hi there and welcome, I'm Nikki Sutton and I help people realise the infinite nature of self and of reality. Spiritual emergency, have you been through it and what's it all about? So I have a question from a viewer and it's from Sue Booker, thank you very much Sue indeed and sending lots of love out to you. I would enjoy knowing your insights on spiritual emergency. I personally was awakened in this manner and now look back upon it as fascinating. Thank you for all you share. Blessings to all. Thank you so much. Okay, so yes, when we look back on it, it is pretty fascinating indeed. This was the nature of my awakening, a spiritual emergency. Now, this is sort of a play on words because it sort of feels like an emergency. This is awakening, but in an emergency sort of way. Or you can have a spiritual emergency after your awakening, sort of as you've gone along your spiritual path a little way. You can have various sort of spiritual emergencies as you have further realizations and things happen. But oftentimes it happens at awakening. It's the start of it. It's an emergency. So it's the play on words. So not only are you emerging, you're emerging from your old self into your new self. So you're emerging into something new. Also, it feels like an emergency, which implies sort of danger and fear and that things are not okay. You know, you need help and assistance. And that's what it can feel like. So what is the emergency then? What's so hectic that's going on? Well, many of you who have been through spiritual awakening, many of you might be going through it at the moment, hence you're here, you know. You find that because your reality sort of crumbles around you because you realize so much stuff, it feels like an emergency because you're losing control of your reality. You don't know, well, what's real and what's not. You're trying to rebuild yourself and your sense of reality so that you can feel safe. You felt sort of safe and secure generally in life as it was. You might have been sort of struggling emotionally with something. You might have been sort of thinking maybe reality isn't quite what it seems, and then you may have had a traumatic event happen to you or a paranormal event or come across some information or had a transformative, meditative or psychedelic experience or ongoing circumstances may have led to your awakening. These are triggers of awakening. And all of a sudden, everything shifts because you realize something key. There's usually a first thing that you realize that really triggers it off. Like you have an experience, like an out-of-body experience, or you witness an apparition or something. Or you have precognition and it comes true, or a precognitive dream which comes true. Or, as I say, you have an amazing experience during meditation, you experience oneness. Or a traumatic event causes your reality to collapse, like what happened to me, and therefore I looked into things I was quite interested in the past, i.e. spirituality, and the information started flowing. Someone could tell you something that made you think, hang on, there's some truth in that, and then you start looking into it further. And the emergency happens when your concept of reality falls down all at once. You knew things as they were, that's safe, that's good, I'm in control, and all of a sudden you realize, oh, maybe death is a lie, reality consists of energy, what is this reality then? What's happening in our system? Are we controlled in ways I don't understand? Let me try and find that out. All the paranormal things that have ever happened, even if one of them is true, then that says a lot, doesn't it, about reality and the sense of self. What am I then? What can I do to make myself feel better, to feel happier, to find peace? Everything I've been chasing in life, is it all an illusion? You know, all this success and gossip and consumerism and get likes and feel better sort of social media thing is all, you know, it did feel empty, but wow, maybe this has been sold to me and maybe it's not really going to be my priorities anymore. So all of your priorities are changing. Your friends, you might change your group of friends or be alone for a long while. There's so much that happens during awakening. I cannot even go through it in one video. You change your values, your beliefs, your perceptions, behaviors, thoughts change. And you go through this searching and seeking stage, trying to put pieces of reality back together again, searching and seeking for information to make sense of everything. It's emergency because everything is falling down. How can you function? How can you go out your front door, go to work, interact with people when you're not sure if any of it is real or worthwhile or beneficial or has overriding benefit to humanity and the world or anything? Nothing is what it seems anymore, which is terribly dangerous to the ego, to the sense of self, to everything about you. You are no longer what you thought you were. So what the hell are you? How am I going to function now? That is an emergency. It's a massive dent to your confidence. Many have serious anxiety and even depression because a lot comes out. There's a big purging that happens, purging of energy and even the dark night of the soul we can find ourselves in, which is not really a lot of fun. I've had that myself. That darkness we sink into where it's too scary out there and there's negative entities around, many of them thought forms coming out of you. You feel like there's, you know, if you realize that life goes on and maybe spirit actually exists, therefore there must be sort of negative entities around then. And you have to come to terms with the possibility there's things you can't see and then find means to raise your vibration again and protect yourself. And then, you know, you sail along fine. That's not a problem anymore. But for a while, it is a pretty big problem because in your mind, you think it is a terrible problem. You can feel like you're being watched by whoever, because you know too much. You end up psychically wide open. That's an emergency in itself. Awakening is a shift in consciousness caused by the triggering event. And then that consciousness shifts your consciousness to a place where you're wide open and most vulnerable and absorbing lots of information, but also absorbing energies and psychic interference from all around, from other human beings, maybe from spirit, from the mass consciousness. You start getting downloads of wisdom and information into your mind, sometimes all at once, because spirit says, hey, it's time now. And you have to say, okay, thanks, but slow down. They're there to take care of you. But there's been a lot knocking at the door of your mind for a really long time. Once you open them, it's like it's all stacked up against it and just falls into your mind. There's a lot of remembering that comes like a whoosh, like a wave. It's too much. It's an emergency. But at the same time, you're emerging from your old self. But there's that transition period. Sometimes it's weeks, depending on the significance, so depending how wide open you've been blown, or depending on your background. There's a transition period, can be weeks, can be months, or even a year or two before you feel better. If you've come from a background which is kind of open-minded about spiritual stuff, then it might not be such a shock, but still can be. If you come from a religious background, you can be more open to things of a unusual nature. How, like the concept of God, you know, but also many who come from a religious background are very fearful of all what they're doing during their spiritual practice is wrong, because it can be wrong to meditate, wrong to do yoga, wrong to contact your spirit guides. So then there's this guilt over what you're doing, and then you can feel completely out of alignment from your community, especially if it's a religious community, like what you're doing is wrong and you can't tell anyone, you can't relate to anyone. If everyone around you is an atheist, they might think you're silly and laugh at you, poke fun at you, and just harshly disagree with everything you're saying. I mean, there's so much I could go into. But indeed, Sue, it definitely is fascinating, and that was your route into awakening. And I hope you have managed to traverse the process. I have a feeling you have. And put the pieces of self back together again and the pieces of reality back together again. And we do that through finding stuff out and conversing with other people, wonderful people who have awakened too. And it starts to settle down after a while. It's not such an emergency anymore. Once the emergency has been dealt with, you then start to heal. It's like if you're in an accident or something in real life, then that's an emergency, and then you are fixed up, you know, you go to hospital, and then you start to heal, so the emergency passes, and you know, you put yourself back together again. So looking back, you know, it's supposed to be impactful. If you awaken in that nature as a massive emergency, it's likely for a reason. It's meant to be impactful. So you'll mark it as a turning point in your life, something super significant. If it, for many people, it's more of a gentle ride, a gentle awakening. And it just depends on the individual and how much they get surprised, you know. If it's a big surprise, it's an impactful emergency awakening. But it's supposed to be impactful, so you mark it as a turning point. For me, it was so impactful that I ended up doing this stuff for the rest of my life. Well, hopefully, you know, I've got some life ahead of me, so hopefully I'll continue. Well, I will be. I intend to. It was that impactful that I decided to help others through awakening. That's part of what I do, helping people through awakening. And onward. That's how impactful it was. And that was, I was meant to sit up and take notice, couldn't help but take notice. That was the way it was supposed to be. So maybe for you too, if it's a serious emergency, it's significant in your life, therefore it's meaningful, probably ongoing, definitely. But it must run its course. You must allow the emergency to run its course, because as I say, it's happening for a reason. You're meant to spend part of your life under illusions, sort of sleeping or whatever, under earthly illusions, and then the rest of it not. So it's happening for a reason, and perhaps your higher self thought, okay, now's a good time, or you're meant to awaken at this time. But we should sometimes attempt to steer the spiritual emergency into a more positive direction. You know, we allow it to run its course, but it doesn't have to run its course unfettered, uncontrolled. If we're going down a fearful negative path, for example, if we are looking a lot into the truther movement and what's going on in society and what's kept from us, we end up over focusing on that. It's important, but it can make us feel pretty dark there, as it did for me. So it's good to balance that with spiritual practice, like meditation, like grounding, having bare feet outside on the grass, like salt baths, smudging, breathing techniques, guided meditations, and lots of other practices too, developing your inner senses, developing your psychic abilities. Although maybe hang off from that at first because you're quite wide open anyway, but thinking about, at least reading about these things, or reading material of a more spiritual nature, sort of purely opening your mind to the spiritual nature of self and reality, balancing that with the truth of stuff instead of just focusing on the truth of stuff, which can bring you down a bit. So take breaks from that if you're in a big emergency. So meditation and mindfulness, our thoughts are going round and round and round when we're in spiritual awakening emergency. We're swimming in thoughts, figuring things out. There's new neurons making connections in our mind continuously. Our consciousness is upgrading and we're downloading a lot. So therefore, being swept up in thoughts all the time, we're just in our heads all the time. So you can bring yourself into the now, observe what's around you, close your eyes then, and listen to what's around you. Listen to your breath, observe how you feel, listen to any sounds around you. Be here now, in the words of Ram Dass, be here now, so that you can observe. Step outside of those thoughts and the whirring mind, which is taking you into darker dimensions, and just be in this moment, which holds nothing but love and potential, because everything from the past is there, everything from the future is over there, but you're here and none of that influences you here in the now, which is nothing but pure potential and love. So mindfulness really helps. So self-care, just literally taking care of yourself, cleansing your body and your cupboards, kitchen cupboards of all the crap, and getting some healthier food in that helps to raise your vibration no end, and other positive self-care rituals, sound baths and using sound, tincture bells, singing bowls, tuning forks as well, just to reset your vibration, because sound can really just attune your vibration to a positive place. Meditation music, you notice how different the energies sound in a room when you put on pleasant music. Not sad music, although that has benefits too, because it helps to bring stuff up from the subconscious mind for healing. You notice you feel sad with sad music, then you pay attention to how you feel. But during spiritual emergency, some calming, pleasant music just helps to calm and settle your vibration. In addition, another sense that helps you raise your vibration and calm and settle is the sense of smell. So burning some nice incense, rose, lavender, sandalwood, and smudging with the good old sage as well. So there's lots of self-care practices and routines. Take a break from this emergency you're happening. I know that sounds preposterous because you're completely immersed in this emergency. It's all that matters. But hang on, look around. There's other things that matter too right now. Just pull your consciousness out of that emergency right now. You're safe and well, okay, in your home. So pull yourself out of it and perform some self-care, mindfulness. Just give yourself a break for half a day before you feel that urge taking you to search and seek for more information for your mind to swim in. Just try and take a little break for a while and know that you're just as safe and well as you've always been, no matter, even though your reality is shifting in your mind, which is very valid, on the outer side of things, in the outer world, it's still the same. I mean, things are changing and not always in the best directions, indeed. But, you know, the outer world is still the same. It's just your mind is perceiving everything so differently. So it seems like the world has suddenly shifted. And actually, it's still the same and hasn't suddenly shifted. Your perceptions make it seem like everything has suddenly changed and you have suddenly changed. You are suddenly changing. But the world is still there and you can just come back to that eventually. You are the one that's changing inside, so it makes it seem like everything is changing, unsafe, unreal. Take it easy, take your time, and things will settle again. Know that you're not alone. Know that it totally is life-shattering, but people get through it, and you can do. Definitely, it's a transformation that happens on purpose. It's an upgrade in your consciousness. It's realizing the truth in many things. We all have our own truths, and you can use your intuition. Your intuition is your internal compass telling you the best way to go, suggesting the best way to go, and what's positive, what's negative, using your intuition with your sources of information, what to do next, listening to your feelings. Sorry, that's another point, is that when we are purging and in the emergency, it's all coming up. A lot of the time we might try and force it back down because it's too scary or painful to face. But usually these feelings subside when we sit and listen to them and say, okay, what's up? Tell me about it. You're talking to yourself. You're talking to your subconscious mind. So it's conscious mind talking to subconscious mind. Tell me how you're feeling, me. How can I help? And then talk yourself through it, because then the subconscious mind is comforted. Challenges and problems are resolved. If we force those feelings back down, not paying attention to them, they don't get resolved and they come back and repeat on us later. So work through those by just stepping outside of them and addressing them self to self. Okay, so thanks so much for listening. Please visit nickisutton.com. I've got some great online interactive courses there, and one of them is free. And please consider supporting my channel via Patreon. You receive any question answered over there. Just read the tiers of support and you can see what's what. And then I can bring you more videos like this one. It helps to support my work. Thank you so much. So sending lots of love and all the best. And remember to click subscribe if you're not already a subscriber to receive regular spiritual inspiration on your journey through life. And hit that bell button too for notifications, because we're raising the mass vibration together. So go now in love and peace.